You lazy, greedy, mother truckers. How could you do this? You fucked up. Victoria 3, a game that has been in development now for fucking ages. It's been like, what, 12 years since the launch of Victoria 2. One of Paradox jewels. Like the game that pretty much saved the company and also built its reputation. And you do this? You cannot justify this game for €49.99. You cannot justify this game. This is a scam. I have been a Paradox fanboy in sort of way. I have loved their games probably over two decades right now. And I'm gonna tell you right now, Paradox, you are on a really thin ice right now. You are on a path, a dark path. You need to fucking turn around. This is not the path you wanna go to. I have seen this path taken by so many companies, and they all fucked up. They have all become something that you hate, that the public fucking hate. Paradox, you need to fucking turn around right now. I love Victoria 2. It's one of my absolute favorite pastime games. I still play it today. I think it's a fantastic game. I love the market system. I love the warfare system. Sure, the AI is not a great challenging. They like to stack wipe. Absolutely, the AI needs to be reworked in that game. And I love the naval warfare and the blockade and all that sort of thing. Strategy, we have to think. And people who like this new warfare, where you don't have a single ounce of fucking control of the army or the navy, all you can do is to mobilize them and tell them to either advance, defend, or just stand by. And then you have some sort of really pathetic, lazy animation on the map where you only see some cannons firing. While in Victoria 2, you can see fucking armies fighting. A front line almost. If you play Victoria 2 on multiplayer when it fucking works, it's so fucking good. And me and my friend who played Victoria 3 right now, like last night, we just, after like what, six hours probably, we just looked at each other and just said, dude, we want our fucking money back. This is a fucking scam. This is not a €49.99 game. This is a fucking mobile game. Whoever says they like this game just because of warfare, you are fucking dumb. You are not a proper strategy lover as I am. I love the old Total War where you have to think. You have to use your brain to play mind games with the AI. The only good things I can say about Victoria 3 is, first of all, yes, it is visually amazing. I love the map. It's so fucking good. And I love that the city is expanding when you build factories and that sort of thing. And I absolutely love the diplomacy and all the different choices you can do in the world. Treaty ports, conquering, colonizing, declare interest, trade agreement. But that's all the positive thing I can say about this game. The rest is fucking garbage. I don't understand. 12 years for a fucking mobile game. Yes, this is a fucking mobile game on a PC. You cannot justify this. This is a scam. This is not a $49.99 game. This is not a deep, in-depth game about society and economy in the Victorian age. No! No! Absolutely not. For example, the trade or the market, it fucking is nagging me to the core. It's annoying me. Why the fuck should I end up making by importing certain things from the market to the factory. Why do I have to do that? The factories, the capitalists, and the companies, they can do that themselves. What the fuck do I need to do that? Like, you can create so fucking many factories, and you can have like the entire nation crying out for resources, but you can only do it. It's so fucking dumb. Like, the old system was so good, where everything was just done automatically, depending on the capital, how rich capitalism, the aristocrats and all that sort of thing. They did it by themselves. The game did that by themselves because it had that system as we have today. You don't see someone in the cabinet just going to nation asking for specific resources. No, it's not how it fucking works. No! And the colonizing in this game, it's what the fuck? I played in Sweden and I managed to fucking conquer half of the entirety of Africa. I have three deports in China. I became a global economic superpower. I was so much more rich than Great Britain, France, Russia, United States combined. And all of that just took 10 years in-game. What the fuck is this? And the AI is so fucking dumb. I can understand this new warfare system. It's more fair to the AI because the AI just don't know how to fucking handle the warfare except for the Hoi 4 and all other Paradox game. But the AI is so fucking dumb. It doesn't even follow the path of kind of like a historical path. The United States doesn't follow a historic path. It's like, for me, I played several right now playthroughs, even as some of them as the United States. But as an outsider nation, watching, observing the United States, they abolished slavery like in 1840 or even less than 1838. They never expand, they never do the Manifest Destiny, they never do the Monroe Doctrine. They are pushovers. And then I try to play as the United States and try to do the Manifest Destiny and the Monroe Doctrine, that sort of thing. It fucking sucks. I couldn't do anything. And some say, oh, then you're bad at the game. You have to build that factory. Yeah, I took so many tips and all that from people who say they are, air quote, professional Paradox gamer, or just the good gamers of Victoria 3. You fucking sucks as well, because this sort of system just doesn't work. All the people who say that who are positive for this game, they are fucking dumb. They are not proper strategy or even good old Paradox gamers. And Prussia, like in Victoria 2, you have to use influence, you have to do diplomatic cunning to keep all your neighbors together, to unify to the North German Confederation. And then you have to outmaneuver diplomatically Austria from other states. And then you have to, I would say there's like three stages for Germany. Diplomatically, in the beginning, to make sure and secure your influence and the formation of the North German Confederation. Next is warfare. You go to war against Austria for homogeny over the southern states of Germany, like Bavaria, Württemberg, and Baden, and that sort of thing. And then you go to war with France for Alsace-Lorraine. And the third one is economically. You build up the nation. You're now building up your economy, your factories, to support your armies, to defend the nation, and to expand into Africa and secure new resources. Prussia in Victoria 3 is super aggressive. It immediately fuck all on diplomacy and declare wars on its neighbors, its allies, just to form the North German Confederation. And it does it super early. The fastest I've seen it done was like 4 years into the game. But yeah, the AI for different nature and astrophy, it's brain dead. This is an imperator situation we have right now. Some people just don't want to see it. They don't want to see you outside the fucking bubble. And I can tell you this. I will love it if this game will have an imperator path. Like, it will be good or even better if they work on it. Because right now, it feels like a lazy attempt at Victoria 3. Fucking 12 years. I think it must have been. They have 12 fucking years to make one of the crown jewels of the past to make it even better. But so far they just done. To me, this is like Anthem with BioWare. They have so many years to develop this game and they just shit on it. It looks fantastically visually, but the rest is fucking garbage. And after me and my friend first playthrough together on multiplayer, when we said, we just looked at each other and said, fuck this game. So we refunded the game. I managed to get my money back, but my friend didn't. So I split the money. I insisted to him, like, take the fucking money. Paradox fucking scammed us. And so many people just wanna be scammed. I don't understand how you can like this game. I don't understand why you like this game. Because I can actually see the fruit fucking hands right now. And all the big YouTubers who mostly associate with a Paradox game or that sort of thing, very few of them have openly said what they actually think about the game. And I give them my respect for that. But some of them have taken Paradox money and said it's a good game. It's a good game. And then their fucking subscribers and that sort of thing, and trolls and all that sort of thing, say, oh, but this YouTuber said it was nothing wrong. Like, you fuckers. Obviously, it was paid. This goes down one of the worst fucking Paradox game I ever played. I'd rather even play Victoria 1. I'd rather play Imperator at launch than this game. This is not a fucking $49.99 game. Are you fucking insane? Paradox, you need to fucking turn around right now. Because this, if you keep doing this, because right now I can tell you, every single fucking DLC for this game shall be free. This is unacceptable.